This video has been developed by the Women's and Men's Health Physiotherapy team at Oxford University Hospitals. Our contact details are provided at the end of this video, should you have any questions. The aim of this video is to gain an understanding of the role of the pelvic floor muscles, to learn how to correctly activate the muscles, and to begin a pelvic floor strengthening program. There are a number of reasons why you may be encouraged to perform pelvic floor exercises. Performing pelvic floor exercises during pregnancy and following birth reduces your chance of experiencing urinary incontinence both during your pregnancy and after the birth of your baby. There is also good evidence that supervised pelvic floor muscle training, so working with your physiotherapist to ensure correct technique, may improve symptoms of both urinary incontinence and pelvic organ prolapse. In many women experiencing these symptoms, pelvic floor strengthening exercises are now recommended as the first line in the management of these conditions. Let's now talk about where the pelvic floor muscles are and their role. The pelvic floor muscles attach to the pubic bone at the front of your pelvis and run underneath to attach to the tailbone at the base of your spine. They get their name because they form the floor of the pelvis. The pelvic floor muscles encircle the neck of the bladder, the vagina, and the back passage. The muscles tighten and close around these openings and also lift up to support the bladder, uterus, and bowel. So, the pelvic floor muscles have important roles in maintaining continence, supporting the pelvic organs, and also have an important role in sexual response. You can perform your pelvic floor exercises in a number of different positions. You may wish to start in lying. For example, lying on your back with your legs bent and your feet hip-width apart. During pregnancy, we don't recommend lying flat on your back. Try a side-lying position. Sitting is another good position, but try to avoid slump sitting. Instead, try sitting forward towards the front of the chair, have your legs comfortably apart, and lean forward slightly with your hands resting on your knees. As your pelvic floor muscles start to get stronger, try to move into a standing position. So performing your exercises in standing, again, with feet comfortably apart and keeping your knees soft. Establishing the correct technique for pelvic floor activation is essential. There are a number of visual cues or images we use to help correctly activate the pelvic floor muscles. These include imagining that you are trying to stop yourself from passing wind, or trying to stop your flow of urine, or drawing a tampon or marble up inside. We are looking for a tightening and lifting up around the vagina and back passage. Importantly, we want to avoid bringing in other muscle groups. So avoid squeezing your legs together, clenching your buttocks, and tightening your abdominal muscles too much. A gentle pulling in of your low abdominals is okay. We also want to make sure that you can keep breathing throughout the exercises, so avoid holding your breath. Let's start by focusing around the back passage. Find your comfortable position. Now, start to tighten and pull in around the back passage as if you're holding wind. Keep zipping up towards the pubic bone as if you're stopping the flow of urine. And now, relax and let go. So let's try that again. Tighten and pull in around the back passage and keep zipping up towards the front. Now, relax and let go. Have a think about whether you could feel the tighten and pull up, but also, importantly, whether you could feel the let go. We often focus on two types of exercises. Slow, timed contractions, which focus on the endurance of the muscles, and fast contractions, which are important for strength and our ability to react quickly to activities such as coughing and sneezing, which may put pressure on the bladder. For the timed contractions, we first need to establish how long you can hold a pelvic floor squeeze for at the moment. As we did before, start by tightening and pulling in around the back passage and zipping up towards the front. Now, hold this contraction but keep breathing normally. As you feel the pelvic floor contractions start to fade away, release and let go fully. How long could you hold the contraction for before it faded away? This is your starting point. If you can already hold for 10 seconds or more, Work with a 10-second hold. Now repeat this squeeze and try to work out how many you can do in a row, up to 10 repetitions. For example, your starting point may be a 5-second hold and 5 repetitions. Aim to gradually increase your hold and repetitions as you feel able to. A good goal is to hold for 10 seconds with up to 8 to 10 repetitions, resting for 4 to 5 seconds in between each repetition. If you're not sure how long you can hold a pelvic floor squeeze for using this technique, start with a short contraction and gradually increase. For example, start with a 3-second hold. So, tighten and pull up the pelvic floor muscles and hold 2, 3, and then relax and let go. If you feel that you can do that, then you could try a 4-second hold or a 5-second hold and gradually work up until you're at a 10-second hold. Again, you also need to work out how many repetitions you can do in a row. Okay, so let's now try the fast contractions. The reason for this exercise is to build the strength or power of our pelvic floor muscles so that we can react quickly for activities such as coughing or jumping. In your comfortable position, tighten the pelvic floor muscle using the technique previously described. Hold for only 1 second and then release fully. Rest for 1 to 2 seconds. This should be a strong and quick pelvic floor squeeze. Aim to repeat this up to 10 repetitions, but do ensure a full let go in between each repetition. Your pelvic floor strengthening program is a combination of both the endurance holds and the quick squeezes. Aim to perform both of these, up to 10 repetitions of each, 3 times a day. The NHS Squeezy app is a great resource to help with compliance with your exercise program. Some women watching this video may have recently had a baby and be wondering if this advice is right for them. The answer is yes. You can start your pelvic floor exercises early after birth, as long as you're comfortable and you don't have a catheter. Wait until your catheter is removed before starting the exercises. You should start the exercises gently, but do gradually build up your endurance holds and repetitions. The exercises should not cause any discomfort, and you may find it easier to start in lying before progressing to sitting and standing positions. For women in the first few weeks following birth, start gently with shorter holds and less repetitions. Still aim to do the exercises 3 times per day. Lying may be easier to start, but progress to sitting and standing, and the exercises should not cause any discomfort. We're now going to think about how we can use our pelvic floor muscles in our daily life, something we call the knack. When there is an increase in pressure in the abdomen or tummy, such with a cough, sneeze, lifting, or even standing up, there is also increased pressure on the bladder. Our pelvic floor needs to be able to respond to this. The knack refers to using your pelvic floor muscles functionally throughout the day. It involves tightening the pelvic floor muscles immediately before and during exertional activities. For example, try tightening your pelvic floor just before sneezing, coughing, or lifting, and try to maintain the pelvic floor activation for the duration of that cough, sneeze, or lift. This helps to build the functional capacity of the pelvic floor and improve support of the pelvic organs during the activity. As mentioned, in order to build your pelvic floor strength, correct pelvic floor activation is essential. We know that over 1/3 of women will perform the exercises incorrectly. This could involve pushing down rather than tightening and pulling up the pelvic floor muscles, or clenching your buttock muscles, or squeezing the legs together. As part of your pelvic floor physiotherapy, we will offer you a pelvic floor assessment. The best way to do this is with an internal vaginal examination. With this assessment, we can assess not only your technique with pelvic floor exercises, but how strong the muscles are and their endurance, or how long you can squeeze for and how many you can do in a row. Many women find this assessment very valuable. At your follow-up consultation, we will discuss this assessment with you. answer any questions, and let you decide whether you would like to have this assessment done. After watching this video, we hope that you will feel confident to start a pelvic floor strengthening program. Some key points to remember are: avoid holding your breath whilst doing your pelvic floor exercises. The effort to engage your pelvic floor can vary depending on your position. It is easier to perform the exercises in sitting or lying, but gradually aim for a standing position. Avoid engaging buttock and inner thigh muscles whilst performing your exercises. Establish a regular exercise routine. Consider using the Squeezy app. If you have any concerns, please discuss them with your physiotherapist in your follow-up consultation. We hope you can now put this information into practice and start your pelvic floor exercise program. A member of our team will be in contact to discuss and plan the next part of your physiotherapy management.